Star Citizen, SSD versus NVMe. Can you run on a hard drive? No, get rid of that, throw it in a bin, destroy it. We're gonna do some quick tests. We're gonna get into the menu, then into the game, then fly around a bit, and then run around Lorville. Okay, here we go. So all three drives running at the same time, loading into the game. As you'd expect, the hard drive is gonna be slow. The NVMe and the SSD basically trade blows. So you could run this a few different times and they're pretty much the same. One might be faster one time, one the other. Different things going on in the background and your computer might just affect that. But yeah, as you can see, they're pretty much the same. Bang on into the game in about 29 seconds. So there you go. We've got to speed it up for the hard drive. This is going 10 times fast, 10 times faster than it would do. And it's not fun. It's not pretty. You really, 2 minutes, 12, not great. You don't want to be playing on that. You don't want to be loading in on that. It's just not much fun. So next one is to just now get in game, from the menu into game. So just sped it up here just to keep it nice and quick. So about the same, about a minute for the NVMe and the SSD. And again, the hard drive not having a lot of fun here. Now, we're not really looking here at numbers, FPS or anything like that, because Star Citizen is so server dependent, there isn't any point. Like, you could do loads of different runs, but you're completely dependent on the server. So as we get into the next couple of runs, it's just not about the FPS. So you're looking more for hitches, you're looking for smoothness, I think, when it comes to this. So 5 minutes, nearly 6 minutes, bang on, basically 6 minutes, terrible. Right, here's where it actually gets okay. So we're in space, outside Everest Harbor, and basically in space, when you've not got a lot going on, you're not in a city, the hard drive isn't bad. It's fine. Like, on the Star Citizen website, you've got, on the RSL website, they strongly recommend a hard drive. And I don't know if I agree with that, but basically it is just about playable on some occasions. So we sped up here. But watch here, this is the kind of what's about to come. Massive hitch on the hard drive there as the game loads in Eye to the Moon. So now into Lorville, and this is where it really doesn't go well. So the two on the left, they just load in. The hard drive on this occasion just doesn't load in for ages. So the actual character assets haven't loaded in. And it's just a waiting game, basically. When are they going to go? Again, server performance is massive here. So the NVMe, which I totally can't say, that the door here, the elevator door, just didn't open for ages. So you'll see that I nearly actually shut it down and started the run again. But we'll pause those two there and just wait for the hard drive to kind of catch up. So eventually it loads in. And here you go. This is why you should not be anywhere near a hard drive. You'll see as soon as we could have just ended it here. It's just hitch after hitch after hitch, stuttering all the way through, basically, and it's just no fun. And to be honest, it actually plays worse than it looks. Like, it looks bad, but actually when you're playing, you're expecting the movement, it's pretty disorientated, it's not great. So I just think if you've got a hard drive and you're playing this game on a hard drive, you're not doing yourself any favors. Just get an SSD, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But yeah, you see there that it does take a while to load in there, and it's just continual hitches. It's not to say that the other two drives don't occasionally have hitches and stutters, especially kind of in the bigger areas, kind of cities and the landing zones. So I think the SSD has a couple coming up maybe in a minute, and there's one for the SSD, and the NVMe definitely also has one that comes up, another one on the SSD there. So they're not perfect, but it is complete night and day compared to the hard drive. So there's another one for the hard drive, and it's just no good. And I think now that the price of an SSD is so low, like they're so cheap, it's crazy. You don't even really have to get a high performing SSD. Any old one will be 100 times, that's probably bad maths, but a lot better than a hard drive. So yeah, we'll get onto the other two in a minute, but basically, if you've got a hard drive, just buy an SSD. That's basically the scenario here. It's just no good for this game. So yeah, hard drive, just don't bother. The other two, well, it's pretty close. At this stage, at this point in development, there's not a whole heap of difference between an SSD and an NVMe. There just isn't. I would say, in my experience, the NVMe feels smoother, but maybe that's just because I bought one and I thought, well, it's placebo effect and I'm just willing it to be better. I don't think there's much difference. That's not to say that that won't change as development goes on, but I don't know. I don't think I'd run out and definitely buy one at this point. That said, this is an NVMe on PCI 3.0, so it's not the quickest out there today. It's a Samsung 970 Evo, so it's a quick one, but that's not the fastest option. You've got the Optane stuff from Intel, and also now you've got the PCIe 4 stuff on the new Ryzen motherboard. So this isn't a perfect test. There may be ways to speed up, but again, we're so realistically early on in development with Star Citizen. The whole thing that everybody says, don't buy a PC now for Star Citizen, it just still is true. So just a quick look on Amazon here, and straight away you've got a good-ish, cheap SSD, and yeah, it's not going to be the fastest thing out there, but it's going to be a lot better than a hard drive. So if you are in that space where you're still chugging along on a hard drive, just get yourself on Amazon or wherever you want to buy things, and just do it. Do yourself a favor. It's 2020. It's the worst year imaginable, and basically nobody deserves, on top of everything else that's been going on, to be still running on a hard drive. Hopefully that was helpful. If you want to subscribe, come and follow me on Twitch. When I get to 100,000 Twitch followers, I'm going to get a tattoo of Chris Roberts' face on my foot. Promise, I definitely will do that. See you soon.